عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu narrates, he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan. Wow. Oh Allah, oh Allah. He used to say, oh Allah, I seek your protection. Brothers and sisters, this is powerful. What worry did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have or sadness? Subhanallah, he was the best of creation. We need this dua more than anyone else. Many of us complaining of worry, anxiety. Al-ham also refers to anxiety. And al-hazan or al-huzn refers to sadness. People are sad today, very sad. For what? Over something minor sometimes. And people are suffering with anxiety to the degree that they don't even know what to do. They are worried about the future. They're worried about what's going to happen. So much of anxiety, so much of worry in the mind, in the heart. And it affects the health. It affects everything. It affects those around you. So this dua is very, very powerful. Oh Allah, protect me from anxiety and from sadness. My brothers, my sisters, don't we desperately need this dua? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan. Oh Allah, I seek your protection from anxiety. I seek your protection from worry and from sadness. And hazan could also mean difficulty. It could also translate as difficulty. Alhamdulillah alladhi adhhaba 'anna al-hazan. You know, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has deflected from us or who has saved us from hazan. Hazan meaning sadness as well as difficulty and hardship. The next part of this dua, وَالْعَجْزِ وَالْكَسَلِ. Oh Allah, I seek your protection from inability and I seek your protection from kasal. Kasal here refers to laziness. So these two were mentioned in a previous dua, but the first two were not mentioned. So that's why I've repeated this dua. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن والعجز والكسل. Inability, helplessness. Al-ajz also refers to helplessness. I seek your protection from helplessness and from laziness. Subhanallah. Wal-jubni wal-bukhl. Here come those two characteristics again that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept on seeking protection in Allah from. What are they? Al-jubn, cowardice, the opposite of bravery. You know, someone is brave. We're asking Allah to be brave. And al-bukhl means miserliness, stingy. Subhanallah, a person who doesn't want to spend. Sometimes we have millions, we don't even spend on our own families. And sometimes, you know, it's strange how some people have very little, but they spend. Amazing. We think that this person is wealthy and they're not really wealthy. They're not really wealthy. They're just spending. They are the ones who are known as the wealthy because Allah's blessed them with the ability to give. And then you have others who really have the millions and the billions. They don't give. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be able to give and to be able to, you know, be generous.